Hi everyone. Welcome back to another week of The Guest Life. So I had just gotten down to the lake to film my intro and I'm like, where the heck is my phone? I'm looking in all my pockets and I had just finished wiping out really bad on the way down to the lake. So it fell out of my pocket and it was right where the scene of the crime happened. My elbow is definitely going to be bruised. It's starting to cool down now. I think we saw -9 this morning. So after the melting and a little bit of rain yesterday, it's just sheer ice everywhere. I'm sure I'm going to fall down a few more times today. Anyway, the reason I am down here is John and I are working on, mainly John, pump adjustment like 6 or 7, I'd like to say. Hopefully, fingers crossed, this is going to be the last pump adjustment for the winter season. So for those of you interested in getting water from a pretty available water source like a frozen lake up to your off-grid home or your cabin, keep tuned and maybe some of these ideas you could use. So already we have hard lined relatively straight a pipe all the way down to the lake. Then we have a little attachment attaches to our pump. We drill each time going into the lake and that's how we've been getting our water. But the dream is to have it in full time. So John has purchased heat trace and he's got that all hooked up with the different attachment and we're going to leave the pump in the lake and hopefully it doesn't freeze and hopefully that heat trace does its job and then we can just kind of plug in the heat trace for, we'll play it out. We're gonna start with an hour and see what that does and then plug in the pump and that will be relatively painless. We're just trying to figure out the right angle to get it into deep enough water because we're going to have to lower the pump a little bit more because we want it completely submerged so that there's no ice gathering around the pump. We're going to have to put it a little deeper than usual. And my job right now, I've got my little shovel and my crowbar. I'm going to try pick away at the ice and make a nice little area for John to work with.
Yeah?
Yep. The heat trace will cover any sitting solid frozen water. The rest of this should drain. As soon as we take the filter off inside, it kind of vacuum pushes back all the water down here. So that'll be empty and then it'll sit here frozen. But once you plug in the heat trace, that should take care of that. Okay, I think we got all our angles and levels all organized. Downward slope all the way. It's the main thing. We're gonna pump. So we're gonna try pumping now, make sure that there's no leaks anywhere, and then John's gonna make a little 5-gallon pail insulated bucket to go over the part that's sticking out of the lake. So then when we do plug the heat trace in, it's kind of got a little cozy nest and it'll be more efficient that way. I can't really update you on whether this system's gonna work today because it technically has to freeze first, right, before we try it again. But I will update you on our first attempt at that. Well, we woke up this morning to some snow. As you can see, it's still kind of snowing. Winter is back. I am currently gonna put my finger on the heat trace and see if it's working because we're gonna try pump this water. See if it works, see if the heat trace thawed out what froze last night after we pumped. I'm just busy running around like a little bunny rabbit doing all the chores because tomorrow morning we are headed into town. Tomorrow night we are headed to Saskatoon and then the following morning we are heading to the Dominican Republic. So it's pretty exciting for our family. We've never been on a hot holiday before so we're a little bit nervous but we're going with a bunch of family so it shouldn't be too bad. I'll definitely take some pictures and maybe some little clips for you guys and it's gonna be a weird week this week. There's John's cute little nest. He just kind of cut up a 5-gallon pail and put little insulated bubble wrap we had left over. Oh yeah, definitely warm. It's been plugged in for a little while, so I think I'm gonna set the timer for 50 more minutes and we'll see. I'm planning on, once I plug it in, I'll probably get, oh gosh, the ice is horrible. Woo! I'll probably get a big kid to help me plug it in, and I'm just going to keep my ear out for that like ch-ch-ch-ch-ch sound of ice crawling up the line. And if it is, I'm going to yell at them to unplug it really fast and keep it heating up for a little while longer. Because a little while ago, I had plugged the pump in and a whole bunch of ice got sucked up and ran into the building, and that was it for pumping for that day until John could come and help me. So I don't want that happening again. Well, I plugged the heat trace in for 50 minutes and I plugged the pump in and went just smooth up the line. I was listening for those little icicles. I made sure I was at the extension in the middle of the line so that if I heard it, I could pull it apart, but it ran smooth. Cheese.
Cheese.
Hi everyone. We're leaving Liran. John already asked you to get the plane. We made it back to Canada in one piece. It feels really good to be home. It was a good trip, but I'm kind of a homesick homebody, so I'm quite happy to be back home in our cozy cabin. Everything was good. Dogs are still here. Everybody's happy. It's a little bit chilly this morning, minus 18. It's taking a bit for our bodies to adjust, but it actually doesn't feel too bad out. Me and the little people, we're gonna jump in the truck with Dad and go for a little plow. We got a bit of snow while we were out of the country. Not too much, but enough to have to plow. The old ice road's completely gone. Is it bumpy? Isn't that cool? Yeah. Is Russell sleeping? We usually went over around mark or two that way, but when was that, a week or two ago? We saw some open water there after the warm weather, so there's reefs around there, so we have a better bet going with a place that's a little deeper, so we're gonna go closer to this island and hopefully avoid some rotten ice. There, we got the drone up and running again. John will get some footage for you guys. Maybe a bit too close. Here you can faintly see the banks of the old road. That's what a road looks like once it's been all blown in with snow. Hi, Marley.
Hi, Mommy.
I know it might seem a little excessive to some of you plowing a road out to our home. Hi, that's 17 kilometers away from us. But if you put it into perspective, I think John bought that truck for $1,500. He does his own labor because he's a mechanic, so that helps out tremendously. But it's probably sitting there over exaggerating. He's like $15,000 into it. And that in comparison to the snowmobile, which is about a $20,000 snowmobile, the truck's gonna need less maintenance. And if you've got a nice wide road and it's not very windy or doesn't snow crazy, it'll stay like this for a little while so he can take a different vehicle and just shoot back and forth, nice and comfortable, drink his coffee in the morning. So with that all into play, it does make more sense to drive for us than it does for him to snowmobile every single day to and from work. One of our friends from a cabin down the way must have came out either last night or this morning. We didn't see him drive by, but last night when I came out, it was like his little tiny goat path because John was in front of me. I didn't have a very wide road coming out, and now look at it. Like, we've done a pass onto this, but he definitely did a pass before us, which is nice having neighbors close by with plow trucks, because every single time they're coming out to their cabins, it just gets wider, 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 and then the road lasts a heck of a lot longer. Come on, bud, let's go. I am. Oh, you're cool. Come on, dude. Now off we go to do a pass to John's best buddy's cabin. That'll be a brand spanking new road, so you guys can see how that looks. Never mind. Looks like his brother already punched the road for him. Do a pass and widen it up. A little bit of slush is starting to peek up at the banks of the road.
Water?
Yeah, slush.
It's water, Mom.
Yeah, a little bit of water's coming up through the ice. Hi, what do you have? Big snowball? Are you gonna throw it? One, two, three, throw it! That's not alarming though. We have slush that peaks up around the edges of the road every single year in little spots around the island. I'm surprised we haven't seen slush up to this point. Well, I think I'm gonna wrap the week up there. I've got one more day tomorrow before Sunday hits, so I'll do a little bit of editing for you guys and get this video out. But have a great upcoming week, and we will see you next Sunday. Bye.
Hi, Mom.
Hi, bud.